believe you're God, you have a sacrificial vagina? Do you believe you're God, you have a sacrificial vagina?
No, I want to know this.
I want to know this. Do you believe your God is an entering in a lecture vagina? Do you believe that? Do you believe that? Do you believe that? Do you believe your God can be in an entering in a lecture vagina? Do you believe that? Do you believe that? Do you believe God enter in a little girl vagina?
He just needs to behave himself.
No, behave yourself. I'm answering a simple question.
Can we do it after, not this next week, but the week after that?
Okay, fair enough.
Yes?
Okay, have a good day.
Then answer my question.
All right.
But just make sure
can your God enter in a little girl vagina?
Come on, it's light.
Yeah, there's going to be cameras, we'll talk about it.
Yeah, answer my question then. Can you answer my question?
That question that you've asked, yes, has a different...
No, I don't want it from you. You scared me.
So the Asha, you say something.
Yes, I help. This is why I'm... So part of the reason why I'm asking the question.
Then you're gonna get my opinion.
You're gonna get the Salafist position.
No, you're gonna get the Hanbalist position.
Okay, fair enough.
Whereas, really and truly, with this kind of question, it's not your, like... If I give you one opinion on this answer, it's not going to represent all of Islam. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So what I like to do with Christians, if you don't mind, I like to talk about something where all Muslims can agree. Because if you, let's say you defeat me in an argument, for the sake of argument. Let me just finish with one. If you defeat me in an argument where not all the Muslims agree, then some Muslims are going to say, but he's representing not Islam, but his sectarian denominational position. Is that what I said? So it's better to have a discussion.
But I am asking you.
Here's my view, Bob. I've said to you before already, I take the Hanbalist position,
Go on.
So, no, but I'll tell you before I'll tell you what the Hanbalist position is in a second, but I can tell you. But, having said that, if, once again, my policy is this, my method of discussing with, Christians, Jews, or any other one outside, is I'll tell you what Ash'aris will say about it, I'll tell you what Hanbalis will say about it, and I'll tell you what Maturidis will say. These are the three major groups of creed. Do you get me? Because here, when I'm speaking to you, my thing is not to represent myself, it's to represent Islam. Do you get me?
Brilliant.
Does that make sense? So that's a question that has a difference of opinion with Islam.
But the thing is that there's virtually every topic that you have debated on, Muslims have different positions on.
No.
Like whether Muhammad is in the Bible or not. That is not a universally
held position. Yeah, but it's not creedal.
Exactly.
It's not a creedal thing.
But the question about Allah entering into his creation, you said you would tell me what the Hanbali position is.
So the Hanbali position is that it's possible in a way that only God knows how.
How is that different from the Salafist position?
It's the same. It's the same. Right. The only difference will be...
So there's really two camps? Those that say can and those that say can't.
Some that say that it wouldn't befit His Majesty to do so. Yeah.
So you do believe that Allah can enter into His creation?
The Hanbalite position, which is what I follow, says that, for example, the third of the night and all that stuff is literal. It's actually dhahir.
Literal.
However, I said to you before, my policy when discussing with Christians, Jews, or atheists, or anyone who's non-Muslim, is not to tell you my position.
Yep.
It's to tell you that there's this position and there's also the Ash'ari position, which you could claim is actually majority of Muslims that are Sunni or that claim to be Sunni would follow, which is that actually that's not to be taken literally, but it's metaphoric.
Yeah, I'm aware of the difference.
Yeah. So this is the difference.
So the question is, hijab. I'm willing to go into this debate right now. However, I will be a man of my word. You said you wanted to do this in 2 weeks. So do you want to do it now or do you want to do it in 2 weeks?
No. What I'll say to you is, you can be a man of your word, but what I'll say to you is,
but it's Allah entering into his creation.
No, but here's the thing. That's an issue that Muslims...
That's the one I want to debate.
But on what? My position?
Yes, your position.
So my thing with that, let me tell you now, to save you the time, I'll talk to you about anything else.
Great.
But on these issues, I don't talk about them to non-Muslims. Yeah? I talk about them to Muslims, because with that, let me explain. That's an issue that Muslims have not agreed upon. Does that make sense?
What issues do you talk about?
Let me just finish this off. With Christians, my policy, and Jews and atheists or anyone else, is for me it makes more sense to start off with issues of disagreement like the Trinity, like the crucifixion, the resurrection, incarnation, all those things. All those things were almost
Allah entering into his creation.
I understand, but then find someone else. Find Shamsi. Shamsi will be happy to argue.
Shamsi doesn't. He runs away every time. The reason why I came to you, man, is because I know you're not someone
who runs. No, I don't.
So that's why I wanted
to. But for me, my policy is this. And I've said this to you many times, and I've employed it with anyone who wants to talk to me, yeah? I will not, this is my policy, I will not entertain denominational discussions with non-Muslims. It's like me coming to you and asking you about the Pope.
Yep. Yeah? I'll talk about the Pope.
No, I understand, but look, like, here's the thing. That's things that Christians disagree on. Do you get it?
Yes.
So what I'm saying to you, it would be foolish of me to kind of take on the mantle of a Protestant, or I'm not sure if you're Catholic or Protestant, I don't even know.
I'm just a Christian.
You're an Anglican, I think.
Just
yeah?
a Christian.
Yeah. So let's say you're just a Christian, non-denominational, whatever it may be.
Yep, that's it.
If you're non-denominational Christian, whatever it is, whether you take the position that the Pope is infallible in his rulings and so on, or don't take that position, it's a foolish thing for me and you to debate. You should be debating that with someone who disagrees with you.
If you're going to debate the Trinity, for example, or whether Christ can become a man,
yes,
then he has the right to then reflect back.
Yeah, yeah, but I'm telling you, it's a waste of time.
What you're saying is, you're only
why
debate
if,
and
what I'm saying is on that
is, on issues that
we're not
you
here
like,
look.
But then when he has a point
to
reflect back,
say he beats me, say he beats me in the debate, the majority of Muslims might agree with him. Do you get it? So he's not defeating Islam at all.
So
it's
how
a waste
do you debate
time.
About the Trinity?
It's not a waste of time to me.
Okay, but then
it's not a waste of time.
My remit in
you're corner, saying it's a waste of time.
My remit in Speaker's Corner is not to get into interdenominational discussion.
Is there any Muslim here who is willing to debate Allah entering into
yeah,
his creation?
Yeah, no, go ask someone else because that's not my.
You said you would.
If you want to discuss anything else,
no, I want to debate that.
Can you debate?
You know what I mean? Come on, hijab.
Not on this.
No one can intimidate you in this department. You can debate me.
I would say to you, honestly, if you say to me, what do Muslims say about it? Yeah?
Yeah.
My thing is, Muslims disagree. Simple as
great.
That.
Great. So now explain to me. Hold on one second.
I think we should
Isn't Islam meant to be a perfect guidance to mankind?
Yeah, but interpretations of it are there's different interpretations.
So there's problems with the way that the Quran describes Allah.
On this question of did Allah, can Allah, with his
essence. You don't need to get too feeling. I know I'm attractive, but just hold yourself back.
No, I can't stop it.
I know. I appreciate that. I'm always irresistible to you.
Are you telling men nowadays you're attractive?
Yeah. So tell me.
But, you have like one tone of voice.
You believe it. Am I right? Correct me if I'm wrong.
Why don't you keep quiet?
That the Quran is perfect
no
guidance to mankind.
As usual, no one's talking to
different opinions on all sides.
So something that is perfect guidance to mankind
has a different opinion. Do you get it?
And according to you, Christians,
it's okay
to be naked.
Different opinions.
According to your prophet,
it's almost obvious to be rooted in the Quran.
What a freak.
Your prophet,
being naked is okay. According to him,
issue of entering into creation.
According to your God was naked on the cross.
But what this implies to me is that actually the Quran has failed to be perfect guidance.
Shall I go on?
And they said,
no, the Quran
says. Yeah, that's where your God came from.
Hashim, they suck his penis when they circumcise him.
Calm down,
Bob, stop telling people you look attractive to men.
Paper boy, your God, they suck his penis when they circumcise him.
I've got people shouting this year.
Where is orientation?
Look, we're not going to be able to communicate.
Paper boy. Your God, they suck his penis when they circumcise him. You're an idiot.
Where is the verse of breastfeeding that was in the Quran?
Where is the verse of breastfeeding? Where is the verse when your God breastfeed his mom? Shame on you. Where is the verse? Where is the verse when your God is pregnant his mom? You idiot!
God wants for Hujaina. The reality is you have problems with what the Quran teaches.
Only God wants for Hujaina.
It's also in the Quran. Does it say in the Quran? Does it say in the Quran that Allah's hands are on their hands?
No, but the Quran here.
Does it say that?
Yeah, it does say that, yeah.
Right, so we are talking about...
No, but you didn't say about hand. You said before, your question was to do
with
Muzul.
When Allah's hands...
Muzul is not in the Quran of Allah.
When Allah's hands...
Muzul is in the Hadith.
When Allah's hands are on their hands, is Allah's hands in creation?
Now, here's the thing. So, first of all, let me tell you what all Muslims agree with. Yeah?
Okay, go on.
Yeah, all Muslims agree that Allah's hand is not... What is referred to as Allah's hand is nothing that can be conceived of anthropomorphically.
Right.
In other words,
so it's not a hand.
It's not a physical hand like this or anything.
It's not a hand.
Absolutely not a fleshy hand.
So the Quran is not clear when it says a hand because
absolutely.
That word is meaningless.
No. That word has a meaning, but the meaning it does not. What we know it does not mean What it does not mean is that it is a fleshy hand.
Great.
Of the
that's telling me what it doesn't mean. What does it mean?
So what we know about the hand, anything that's referred to. This like is, okay, good. Good, good, good. So good. So anything to do, my view, yeah? Okay. You want my view? My view on the matter is that when any of the attributes are presented in the Quran, we know what it does not mean. What it does not mean is that it can be related to anything within creation.
Great. Yes. Now answer me this. Yes. Is the point of communication...
It's not going to end, bro.
Is the point of communication... It's a statement.
And you answer my question about your God ruling in
you can't shut up for 2 minutes. So in terms of communication, you would agree. The point of saying something positively is to communicate something.
Read me. Can I read your reference when your God... They suck his penis when this... When they circumcise him.
Yeah, but it's not
can I tell your reference? Is that communication?
Okay, fantastic. Yeah.
Tell me.
From an Ash'ari perspective, this is
metaphor. But you're not Ash'ari.
I understand, but I'm giving you because I'm representing Islam.
But now you're only representing the Ash'ari side.
I'm going to tell you both.
Go on.
The Ash'ari say it's metaphoric or it means power. Okay? For the most part, that's what they will say.
Yeah.
Among the Ash'aris, there are some who will say, actually, it's tafweed. That's a different discussion. A third school of thought will say it has a functional, the only thing that is similar between it and the creation is the functionality. In other words, just like, basically, functionally, Allah's a king. Yeah? Let me explain. Me and you say, oh, God is a king, sovereign, yeah?
Carry on.
So me and you both say God is sovereign, but one of the meanings that the word king entails in a worldly sense is a man. But me and you, I'm not talking about Jesus now, because you say Jesus is a man. But both of us will say the Father is not a man, yeah?
Carry on.
So the word king here, one of the meanings of it, of what it means in this world, is a man. But me and you will say, but actually that's not what is intended. Because the face of Allah, the face of God, the hand of God, and so on, that's also in the Bible. Do you get it? So there's in the same disagreements that existed amongst Muslims, existed amongst Jews and Christians on these issues. I can prove it to you. For example, now hold on, on the questions
you're talking about the hands of Allah.
The hands of God in the Bible, Old Testament.
Yeah.
Yeah, and also the face of God, the eyes, all of that is in the Old Testament. Now, all of that is in the Old Testament and the Bible. Now the question is, how have scholars of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam interpreted those words? Jewish scholars, I've read it myself, Talmudic text, Midrashic text. You can see, if you want references, I can show it to you.
I'm not a Jew.
For example, I'm explaining
the Old Testament.
The Old Testament scholars, if you look at also some of the patristic, commentaries and homilies of the biblical text, some patristic scholars took it literally. Some, like Origen, did not. They were very clear allegorists. So the idea of allegorization of the attributes of God is a question that's not Muslim specific. Do you get it?
But you haven't answered my question.
So what I'm saying to you
after
is,
after all of this, you still haven't answered my
question. Is this
what is communicated in the Quran Allah's hands are on their hands?
Bob, okay, let me explain to you. This question, the answer is this: there's a difference of opinion among Jews, Christians, and Muslims.
We're talking about the Quran.
I'm saying the same things that the Quranic commentators.
Stay with the Quran.
The same thing
that
I have mentioned the Quran.
Exactly.
The same things that the Quranic commentators and Mufassirs or exegetes and also Hebrew experts have disagreed upon. And do you know what I find really interesting about Bob?
So far, all you've said.
Let me say it for this.
All you've said. Bob, let me finish. All you've said. We're talking about everything except the topic. Hijab.
Bob,
the topic is what is communicated by their hands, by Allah's hand on their hands.
Okay, fine.
Does Allah's hand enter into creation? Yes or no?
No, let me explain. Everyone knows, let me explain to you, what all Muslims agree on is Laysa kamithlihi shay'un wa huwa as-sami'u al-basir. Chapter 42, verse 11. All Muslims agree upon that, which is that the fleshy hand that I have here, or the what we refer to as hand in this world, is not what that verse is communicating.
So what is communicated? That was the original question.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's now the fourth time I've repeated myself.
So functionally, so this is where the difference is. An Ash'ari would say it's metaphoric, it means the power of God. An Athari would say, an Athari meaning a Hanbali, meaning a Salafi as well, because it's the same thing. they would say that the hand here is referring to something which is called hand, but functionally operates in a way that only Allah knows best.
Okay, yeah. So and what you're saying is, so is Allah's hand entering into creation?
No, the hand is a sifa, it's not a that. Do you get it?
Is it entering into creation?
No, but hold on.
Whatever you want to call it, is it entering into creation?
Let me explain. There's a difference between a that or sifat.
Is it entering into creation?
Let me explain the answer to the question, yeah?
To my question, not the one you're asking yourself.
Yeah, so the sifat of Allah is in the creation. For example, a sifat, sorry, let me say in English, I'm saying in Arabic. In English, the sifat is an attribute of God.
Yep.
Whereas the essence is called the that.
Yes.
So everyone agrees that the attributes of God can enter the creation, are in the creation. For example, the attributes of God, of knowledge, is God's knowledge is everywhere.
So,
do you get it? God's power is everywhere. God's,
so the attributes are divisible from the essence?
No, they're not divisible.
So where Allah's attributes are, Allah is there?
No, no. What we're saying is
so
that
Allah does enter
we
into
both believe that God is essence knowledge. And attributes.
Does he enter his creation?
We both believe
I think the better term is it manifests in the creation.
Yes, yes.
But it doesn't enter in
the sense
of the essence.
So is the hand,
so the love of Allah, the knowledge of Allah.
Yeah, you get it.
It manifests.
It's an attribute. Yes, yes. So it's an attribute. Enters into
it manifests
creation.
In the creation.
Yeah. Okay. So it enters into creation.
Manifests into creation.
So Allah can enter into creation.
So what was my view?
Manifest doesn't mean
entry. My view is that God can enter creation if he wants to.
I know what it means.
No, you don't know.
But that's not the only view in Islam.
You'll have to forgive me because Hashim is shouting very loudly.
Now, Bob, second thing. Can I say something really important?
Yeah.
Yeah. So here's. But you said yeah, and then you started talking.
Because you can. But I do want to bring you back to the something that you've avoided a several times now.
I haven't avoided anything. I've been asking
so many times. So I'll ask it again, and you'll see why you've avoided it. We have said.
Manifest
very what simple, is communicated when it says Allah's hands are on their hands, because what you've done is say everything it isn't.
Yes,
but you haven't said what it is.
Okay, we don't know what it is.
You don't know. So it's not clear. So it's not clear guidance because you don't know.
We don't know how it operates. We don't know what that means. Yeah, we say
so it's not clear guidance.
We say, yeah, absolutely. We say that in these matters of attributes of God,
yes.
In regards to howness, we don't know how.
So nothing is communicated.
No, it's incomprehensible. It's incomprehensible for us to know how that manifests.
Does the Quran describe itself as being clear guidance?
Exactly. It does, but
it does. Does that apply to all of the Quran or just some of the Quran?
Let me explain. You
lost.
It's not about winning or losing. These people might be actually interested.
I'm interested.
Okay, fine.
That's why I came to you.
No, good.
See, I schooled you again.
So, Bob. Bob, sorry. Let me finish up by saying this.
If you walk naked, you might
George, what's your name?
George.
George. What?
George. Let's go, bro. Come on.
Let me finish. This is an interesting topic. Do you know why? I actually did my research. I looked
brilliant.
At it.
You can talk about it.
But please, Bob.
God wrestles with Jacob.
I beg you, listen.
Hashim, I'm talking to him.
Wait.
Hashim, we have lost. No problem and Jacob with lost. The idea of God entering into creation.
Jacob won. No, I know that.
Muslims are the ones that have a problem with God entering.
When your God entering a little vagina, he now is God or not?
He have no problem walking in that.
Tell me that. Answer that.
I'm honestly trying to answer
that. What I'm saying to you is when I've done my research,
he knows he was God.
Basically, generally speaking, I looked at
God died by his creation.
I looked at the
Hashim.
That's the worst. That's the worst part.
On these issues, forget about the
humiliated
the
and killed
aspect,
by his own creation.
Yeah? Put in the Trinitarian aspect.
He says, my God, why did you abandon me?
Say what you need to say.
Black God, but
George, hold on for a second.
Just tell him to shut up.
1 minute.
Tell him to shut up.
Please.
The guy behind you.
What I'm saying is
toilet
that
paper boy.
Hashim.
Let's go, Muhammad. Yalla.
Give me 1 minute.
I told you we covered
the one thing. What I was going to say is that on my research, putting the hypostatic union to the side.
The question is
about the communication. I was trying to, this George was talking.
The question is about the communication.
Let me just say.
What is communication?
Yes, I'm
the clear guidance that the Quran says that it is.
Bob, don't be ridiculous. Because you're a clever man, yeah?
Yeah, I am.
I'm
trying.
You're a clever man. So you're not ridiculous.
So when it says it's clear guidance, does that apply to all of the Quran or just some of the
You're an intelligent man, so I'm not going to, you know, I'm going to speak to you as if you're a clever guy. What I'm saying is that
hate you after you...
Putting the hypostatic union to the side,
yep.
And putting the Trinitarian cross to the side. Now, looking at what is...
Why don't you walk naked?
George!
What the Quran says.
Have you heard...
Talking about Islam and the Quran.
Now, let me finish. Give me 1 minute.
You
it's Hashim that
all.
Is talking nonsense.
George,
all
man.
It's Hashim. Him that's talking nonsense.
George.
I'm responding to him.
So what I'm saying is that, putting that to the side, what I found,
yes.
Looking at the patristic and the rabbinic material, the
talking
progression.
About the Quran.
Like, hold on. I'm going to make it easier for you to understand.
I don't need to. Just talk about the Quran.
You're a clever man. I'm going to talk about the Quran, believe me. Yeah?
Okay, let's get to the Quran.
The same discussions that commentators and exegetes had
yep.
about the attributes of God, yeah, especially those which have meanings which could be construed as anthropomorphic, mystic, like hand,
yep,
face,
yep,
whatever.
Yep.
Have already been had between Jews and Christians as been had by Muslims. Here's the biggest difference, and this is something I want people to know, yeah.
Okay.
Wallahi, it's such an amazing thing.
Not your sales pitch.
No,
get to the Quran.
Just be quiet for a second.
Just be quiet for a second, man.
Do you know now, the Muslim world, the Sunni Muslim world, those yep. who claim to be Muslim,
yep.
they divide on this issue of Isma' or Sifat, or the issue of names and attributes. Now, what I found mind-boggling is that those same differences that Muslims have now are the same exact differences that Jews and Christians also had. However, the difference is Muslims actually divided into sects because of it, whereas Jews and Christians on these issues never divided into sects because of these issues. You know why?
Because no, you don't tell me. We're talking about the Quran.
Let me just finish.
We're not talking about church history. We're talking about the Quran.
So Bob, allow me. Give me 10 seconds.
Well, stick to the subject, Hijab.
Just give me 10 seconds. I beg you.
Hijab, you've been very patient. You have been speaking. You wasted your time talking about Hadith.
Bob, let me just give me 10 seconds.
What does he say?
10 seconds.
You have said.
I said, you know why? He said, you know why? And I'm going to finish.
No.
Get to the point.
Hijab.
Yeah, I'm trying to get to the point, but the guys
are going to the point. Point of the Quran.
Bro, but you're not letting me talk. I'm not letting you talk. Okay, good. Good.
About
okay.
the Quran.
Do you know why? The reason why the Jews and Christians.
Not the Quran.
Is that no, we're talking about the Quran.
Let me finish off what Quran says. Let me finish. Bro, I can't talk to you.
You can never talk about Islam.
We're not talking about church history. We're talking about Islam.
I'm not
talking about your theology.
Give me 5 seconds.
When it says.
Can you give me 10 seconds? Bro, this is impossible.
Let's go there.
If you're not going to.
In 2 weeks, we'll do it.
Time. It's nonsense.
We'll do it. Time.
No, George,
it's
right. I don't want to hear your voice.
There's a hadith where Muhammad felt the coolness of Allah's hand between his shoulders.
Is that true?
Yes.
Is that true?
That's the hadith.
Did Muhammad feel the coolness of Allah's hand?
Forget it. You guys are.
Sam, hijab, Sam, that
one. All right. So do you know why?
And Nasidawa. And Nasidawa.
Come here. These guys, you can't talk to them. You can't talk to them, man. How do they?
Why do you think we don't talk to them?
Do you know what? I was honourable to them. I said to them, look, you want to talk to me? You've got 2 weeks. I'm not going to chat to this guy now.
Exactly.
Because you know what? Every time I talk to him, he's talking over me. It's like there's no attempt to actually listen to what the interlocutor is saying. But here's what I was going to say. What I found really interesting is this. The Sunni, who refer to themselves as Sunni Muslims, they divide on the issues of Asma or Sifat or the attributes of God. I'm not saying that there shouldn't be sex or there shouldn't be disagreements or nothing. I'm not saying that. But what I'm saying is this is very interesting. When I looked at to the rabbinic and the patristic scholarship on the biblical text, for example, looking at the homilies and commentaries of the Old Testament of the patristic scholars, meaning the scholars that came in early church history, and also of the rabbinic scholars in the Midrashim, I found that they had exactly the same discussions. What is hand? Because it's in the Old Testament. The word hand comes in the Old Testament. The word face of God comes in the Old Testament. So what does that mean? So you got someone like Origen saying it's an allegory. You got someone like Ravi. I think Ishmael says that. He says it's to be taken literally. So there's all this difference of opinion between Jews and Christians. Why haven't they divided into sects because of it? The reason why is because they had so much bigger matters to deal with. They were asking themselves, who was God? And we were asking ourselves, what are the attributes of God?
No,
honestly, this is a serious point. Why did we divide as Sunni Muslims, yeah, or whatever? Why are we divided on issues that we would say are quite minor compared to them? Like, for example, we say, oh, is it ta'wil or is it tafwid or is it isbat? Which one is it of those three when it comes to the hand word, yeah? We all know laysa kamithlihi he shay'un wa huwa as-sami'u al-basir. But which one is it? But these guys had the same differences, but they didn't divide into groups. And the reason why is because they were too busy asking whether the Holy Spirit is God or not. You don't even know who God is, and you're asking us, wallahi, we're in such a better position than these Jews.
Exactly. They don't know whether God is one of them.
The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, it's true, he said, لَتَتَّبِعَنَّ سَنَنْ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ شِبْرًا شِبْرًا وَذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعًا حَتَّى إِذَا دَخَلُوا.
Can you be quiet for a second?
Ignore it, ignore it.
You got the mic.
حَتَّى إِذَا دَخَلُوا جُحْرَ ضَبٍ اتَّبَعْتُمُوهُمْ. You will follow the Jews and Christians.
The King of Kings.
Can be quiet for a second. You will follow the Jews and Christians, arm length by arm length, inch by inch. Even if they went to a lizard hole, that you would follow them into the lizard hole. Meaning, and there's another hadith of iftiraq that the Jews, you know, divided into 72 sects and Christians. Sorry, Jews 71, Christians 72, and then Muslims would be 73 sects. Now the thing is, this is that yes, we have more sects, but our sects scored in history the narcissism of small difference. In other words, our sect, the difference between an Ash'ari and an Athari is so minor compared to for these guys, compared to believing that Jesus is God or he's a subordinate to God, or that the Holy Spirit is, I mean, it's crazy different. They don't even know who God is.
Absolutely.
So yes, we have more sects, but the sects, the differences are not as pronounced. We know who God is. There's no, here's an amazing thing, wallahi. We should be happy about this. All Muslims, there's no controversy of who God is.
Absolutely.
With Christianity, there's controversy, not of what God's attributes are like, but who God is in the first place.
It took them 4 centuries to decide.
Yeah, and they haven't got it even
now. Yeah.
Number one.
Number two, wallahi, it's amazing, yeah? We as Muslims have never had a controversy of what constitutes the Quran.
The Quran is still the same.
No one has a yani. No, there's no sense of we take this as the Quran and you don't take that as the Quran. So we've never had a controversy of who is God. We've never had a controversy of who what the Quran is. And we've never had a controversy of who the Prophet was.
They can't decide how many books are there in the Bible.
If someone comes into Islam, they will know that they're standing on uncontestable ground where there's consensus on these matters. So alhamdulillah, yes, we have our sect, but the differences are minor compared to what you see in Christianity and Judaism. That's what I wanted to say.
JazakAllah khair, brother Hijab. Let's go now.
Nobody talks to us. Let's just see what's going on.
You're going to burn in Hades.
Okay, I'm leaving now.
You have the mic.
Where is Sam camera? Where is Sam?